Case digest on qualified theft. There is qualified theft in the following instances. If the theft is committed by a domestic servant. Second, if committed with grave abuse of confidence. Third, if the property stolen is motorcycle, mail matter, or large cattle. Fourth, if the property stolen consists of coconuts taken from the premises of plantation. Fifth, if the property stolen is taken from a fish pond or fishery. Sixth, if property is taken on the occasion of fire, earthquake, typhoon, volcanic eruption, or any other calamity, vehicular accident, or civil disturbance. GR number 170863, March 20, 2013, Zapanta versus People of the Philippines. The facts of the case, that sometimes in the month of October 2001, in the city of Baguio, Philippines, the accused Anthony V. Zapanta, being then the project manager of Puerta Vaga Building Construction, a project being undertaken then by the construction firm Anmar Inc. under subcontract with A. Mojica Construction and General Services with the duty to manage and implement the fabrication and erection of a structural steel framing of Puerta Vaga Building, including the receipt, audit, and checking of all construction materials delivered at the job site, a position of full trust and confidence, and Corcojo O. Luyao Jr., alias Jun, a telescopic crane operator of Anmar Inc., conspiring, confederating, and mutually aid one another with grave abuse of confidence and with intent of gain, did then and there willfully, unlawfully, and feloniously take, steal, and carry away from the Puerta Vaga project site along Session Road, Baguio City, wide-fledged steel beams of different size with a total value of 2,269,731.69 pesos without the knowledge and consent of the owner, Anmar Inc., represented by its general manager, to the damage and prejudice of Anmar Inc. in the aforementioned sum of 2,269,731.69 pesos Philippine currency. In this June 27, 2005 decision, the CA brushed aside the petitioner's arguments and affirmed the RTC decision convicting the petitioner of qualified theft. It found that the prosecution witnesses' testimonies deserve full credence in the absence of any improper motive to testify falsely against the petitioner. It noted that the petitioner admitted his status as Anmar employee and his receipt of salary from Anmar, not AMCGS. It rejected the petitioner's defense of denial of being self-serving. It, however, deleted the award of moral damages to Engineer Marigudon for lack of justification. The issue of the case, whether or not the CA committed a reversible error in affirming the RTC's decision convicting the petitioner of the crime of qualified theft. Ruling of the case. The elements of qualified theft punishable under Article 310 in relation to Article 308 and 309 of the Revised Penal Code are the following. First, the taking of personal property. Second, the said property belongs to another. Third, the said taking be done with intent to gain. Fourth, it be done without the owner's consent. Fifth, it be accomplished without the use of violence or intimidation against person, nor of force upon things, and six, it is done under any circumstances enumerated in Article 310 of the Revised Penal Code, example, with grave abuse of confidence. All these elements are present in this case. The prosecution's evidence proved through the prosecution's eyewitnesses that upon the petitioner's instruction, several pieces of wide-flange steel beams had been delivered twice in October 2001 and once in November 2001 along Marcos Highway and Mabini Street, Baguio City. The petitioner betrayed the trust and confidence reposed on him when he, as project manager, repeatedly took construction materials from the project site without the authority and consent of Engineer Marigondon, the owner of construction materials. In this case, the testimonial and documentary evidence on record fully established the corpus delicti. The positive testimony of the prosecution witness, particularly Bernardo, Cano, and Buen, stating that petitioner directed them to unload the steel beams along Marcos Highway and Mabili Street of the pretext of a new unmarked project were crucial to the petitioner's conviction. The security logbook entry delivery receipts and photographs prove the existence and the unloading of the steel beams to a different location other than the project site. Therefore, the petitioner should be convicted of qualified theft and with corresponding penalty of reclusion perpetua.